Guys, welcome to the Vlad Kachur Show, the number one show for founders, executives, and entrepreneurs about how to scale businesses. We got with us $3 million, $3 million on the table. And in this video, we're going to talk about the 10 proven ways to increase the productivity of your sales team. So if you have a sales team, you want those reps selling. You want those reps selling your product and making you money. So in this video, we're going to talk about the 10 ways how you can make a lot more money with your sales team. So the first way to increase the productivity of your sales team is to pay your commission fast. I really mean this does magic. You know, my sales reps, I pay them commission within 7 days. From the time we receive the money, they get their commission within 7 days. I know this is hard to do if you have, like, let's say 10 reps, or if you have 20 reps, or if you have 30 reps, but I highly recommend to increase how fast reps get rewarded for their sales, because that way they'll be charged up, right? They'll be excited. They'll move faster and work harder, and they'll be way more productive, right? This solves the productivity issue at the root. Since the rep's getting paid so quickly, he or she's gonna be way more productive. So pay your commission to the sales reps as fast as you can. Number two way, it's about structuring the money, right? So I recommend do 50% base and 50% commission. Now, every time I went outside of this structure, I've always lost, right? Like whenever I get some of these reps, like, hey, they basically want to get 80% or 85% of their money as part of their base. But this never works, right? It always fails, because why? One, they're not driven to crawl to make that extra money. Two, it's like whoever's coming from a background where they want 85% of their money up front as part of the base and not the commission, it's like, those aren't the type of salespeople I want to hire. I want to hire the types of salespeople who want to sell, who want to work hard, who get excited by closing deals. And that's not what you get when it's 85% base. So I highly recommend pay 50% base and then pay 50% OTE, which means on target earnings. So this way they'll work really hard to achieve it. Number three way to increase the productivity of your sales team is extra occasional bonuses. Now, what I mean by that is, let's say you have a team goal, right? You say, hey team, this month, if the team overall achieves this threshold, everyone gets a bonus, right? That way they'll all push harder. Or you can say the top salesman of the month gets this bonus, or you can do a hybrid, right? Like a combination of a top team achieves this minimum, and then the top salesperson gets this bonus. Or you can do what I call a dream initiative. A dream initiative is if every person sets a high goal for themselves, and every person, anybody who achieves that goal, will get some kind of a dream initiative. What's good about the dream initiative is that it's ambitious, right? Like a dream initiative is like you have to push and achieve a big objective. But if you achieve it, you get something you've dreamed of, right? You get like a trip to Asia, all inclusive, or you get a cruise. You get something really, really fun that you want for that month. I love the dream initiative because this way my employees think big, aim big, and if they achieve big, they get rewarded big. So in summary for this point, make sure to give bonuses to your employees and occasional bonuses. And I recommend switch it up. Month to month, try different ones because that'll keep it fresh. Number four, competition between reps. I love competition. I love when my reps go head to head and they start competing with each other. I even highly recommend to put like a sign at the office. As soon as you come into the office, you see the name and how much that person sold this month or this quarter. Because that way the reps will see it and like, oh wow, look how I'm doing. I need to get up higher. I need to prove myself. Competition between reps is magical. If you have one rep, that rep is selling way, way less than they could sell, because if there's two, if three, four of them and they're competing with each other, they're all gonna sell so much more money. And try my board idea. You put a board, name how much you sold this month or this quarter, and update that number every day. I would put a rep in charge of that board, so this way they can update it every day so we can always see, the entire team, entire company could see who's performing, how they're performing, and how much they've sold. Number five, complimenting reps on small things. If you want to increase productivity of your reps, compliment them on the small wins. You know what I noticed? That a lot of times we as people, we are really fast to criticize. We're all so fast to point out what's wrong, what's off, what the person's doing wrong. But we never compliment people. We never compliment people on their small right things. And that's the wrong way to go about it. What you feed grows. Think about that. What you feed grows. So if you compliment a rep on good prospecting, that rep's going to feel really good and prospect even better. If you compliment a rep on a good call, on a good, you know, on a good close, on something small, they will do way more of that and they'll feel way more inspired. So I highly recommend compliment everything your people do, because then they'll feel way more inspired, they'll feel good, and they'll deliver a lot more of that. And the only rule I have for this is make sure it's short, honest, and specific. So that way your compliments are short. If you do a long-winded compliment, they're going to miss it. Short, then honest. Make sure it's honest. If you compliment something, it has to be honest that you believe this is good and specific. Compliment a very specific thing. If it's not one of these, like if you violate one of these three things, your compliment will not work. Make sure your compliments are short, honest, and specific, and then the people will feel inspired and they'll deliver way more for you. And before we go any further, I'd like to briefly say that this video is sponsored by Verb. Now, guys, we get the best sponsors on this YouTube channel. We get the types of sponsors that help you grow. And today's sponsor is Verb. This is a must if you sell anything. If you sell anything, you should absolutely sign up for Verb because you'll make more money. You will sell more of that item. Verb allows you to easily find, present, and share whatever information you need with your clients. Now think about this. Let's say you have a client who needs something. Client asks you to see something. You have a big library of a lot of items that you used to sell. How are you going to share it with them? Here, you can just check mark the items you want to share with that specific client, click share, and they'll even receive that via email or text. And when they click it, they can see the item. They can see these items in one page that's branded with your company. So it's branded with your company, it's not something else. And then you also have analytics. Which items is that client viewing? Which items, when is he viewing those? So then you can follow up because you know what that client is interested in, which documents are getting you the most traction. This is a must-use tool. So this is a great for your sales team because then you can even manage your reps and see which of your sales reps are getting the most action. You can see what clients are looking at, and you'll close more deals. They also have Verb Live, which allows you to sell via live stream. That means you can literally have a live stream and have products here on the page, and people will be able to buy and check out right while watching you interact with them live on video. It's a must. So use this tool to sell more of your product, and you can even use Verb Live e-commerce to sell more via live stream. Click the link below, 7-day free trial. 7-day free trial, and even after the free trial, guess how much it is? I thought it was gonna be so expensive. It's less than 10 bucks a month. Less than 10 bucks a month after the free trial, you're gonna close more deals, you're gonna close more revenue, more clients. Click the link below, sign up for Verb, and you'll make more money. Number 6 way to make your reps more productive is to eliminate the boring work. I know this is tough to do, and this is even harder to do if you have less reps, but if you eliminate the boring work your team does, right? Then you only leave them with the exciting stuff. You leave them with the work they love doing. So I highly recommend eliminate the boring work. For example, like I have what we call like all-purpose AEs. They're AEs, account executives, who do everything. They find the leads themselves, they reach out to the leads, they'll close the leads, and then they manage the leads, right? It's an end-to-end account executive. But none of them enjoy prospecting. A lot of times my reps do not love prospecting, which is finding the actual leads who to sell to. So I highly recommend try to eliminate the boring work as much as you can, because then the people will do just what they love. And if they do what they love, they'll perform better for you. Number 7 way is to give your reps metrics that they should hit. Now, my reps, they should have a sale every single week. So every week, the reps should have a sale. Now, from your end, give your reps the metrics that they should hit, because then they always know if they're behind or if they're ahead, how they're doing. You know, basically what you're seeing is I try to solve productivity at the root. So instead of trying to, you know, find some software and track my reps and track what they're doing, tracking their time, I'm more thinking like, how do I solve the problem at the root so the rep himself or herself is more productive? That's why this strategy of give them a metric to hit every week. Say every week, I need you to sell one lead. Then the rep himself will be more productive, because he's gonna say, listen, have I sold it or not sold it? If you sold it, you're a champion. But if you haven't sold it, you're behind. So give your reps, make sure they have a clear metric to hit every week. And if they hit that metric, then you know it's a champion. They were already very productive because they achieved the metric you need them to achieve. Number 8, give your reps all of the scripts, flows, and FAQs, all the FAQs that they need. Give them everything, because if you leave a rep without guidance, meaning you did not provide them all the tools, all the information, right? I'm talking from an information point of view, that they need to succeed, your rep will not be productive. Give them the scripts. Teach them the scripts. Give them the FAQs. Teach them the FAQs. Quiz them on the FAQs. So this way, the rep will know everything they need to know to be very successful at your job. If you just give the information Without quizzing, without testing, you're gonna lose. If the rep has to spend time thinking and invent that stuff, you're gonna lose. So give your reps the content they need to be successful, because without it, they're gonna spend so much more time and they're gonna close way less leads. Number 9, give your reps the tools they need for success, guys. Give it to them. For example, I give my reps brand new Mac, right? Like all my reps get a brand new Mac. The other day, one of my reps even found some useful document software, right? It's some software she found that helps her get clients to sign earlier, right? So that way clients can sign quicker or easier. She found it. She's like, hey, I'll be able to close more leads. And of course, we bought it for her. So give your reps the tools they need to be successful. I used to try to save on this. Believe it or not, whenever we were starting out, right? Like now we're sitting here, there's a lot of cash, there's a lot of money, right? Like, but when we were starting out, we didn't have anything. Like, and I literally used to give my reps not MacBooks. We used to specifically give them the cheaper laptops. But guess what? We're paying these expensive smart people a high salary, expecting good results, yet we're giving them a slow computer or a computer that's going to be slow, that catches problems. And I realized it was just a stupid decision. Why am I hiring a world-class person, somebody who's incredible, somebody who's talented, but giving that person a bad equipment? Like, it's a huge loss. It doesn't make sense from a money point of view. So I started getting the best. Let's give them a Mac. Let's give them a new Mac. Let's buy them the software they need. So give your reps the tools and things they need to be successful, because without them, you're paying this very expensive person, very smart person, a high salary, but you're saving on something that makes that person much slower and worse off. So don't do that. And the last point, number 10, is give your reps a plan how to spend each day. Now, by that, I mean, like, what should be the plan for your reps? Like, I'll give you an example of what I'm talking about. Like, my sales reps, they should hit 25 new leads every Monday. So every Monday, my reps should hit 25 new leads every Monday. Then on Tuesday, they should follow up with everyone pending from last week. Everyone pending from last week, they should follow up. Why Tuesday? Because on Monday, people are busy. And on Tuesday, people are more welcoming. So that way, they follow up on Tuesdays. On Wednesday, they follow up with the leads who did not respond that they reached out to on Monday. On Thursday, they're answering. And on Friday, they're prospecting. You see how specific that is? That means every week they need to hit 25 new leads. Give your reps a daily plan. So that means their day is laid out. They have an exact plan, what they should do, when they should do it, and how they should do it. If your reps have that, they're going to be very productive. So there you have it, guys, the 10 proven ways to increase the productivity of your sales team. If you've enjoyed this video, click that subscribe button. If you have somebody who could benefit from this, if you know somebody who's either selling himself or trying to grow their sales team or already has a sales team or looking to scale a sales team, click that share button, forward this video to your friend, whoever your friend is, because then they can use these tips and make more money as a result to you, meaning your friend will make more money due to your help. So click the share button, get this video out to more people. You'll help others make more money and good karma will come back to you, and you're also gonna benefit in some kind of a way. And thank you so much to Verb for sponsoring this video. Verb is a great tool to find, present, and share content. So this way your reps will be more productive. They will close more deals because they'll have all the content that they need to sell organized. They can professionally share it and close more leads. And you have a lot of analytics, how your potential customers are responding with the information you share with them. So it'll help you close more deals. They also have the Verb Live, which is the live streaming. You can have a live streaming with selling your products on the screen. Think about that. Live streaming and selling your products on the screen. So click the link below, sign up for Verb, make more money, make your reps more productive, make yourself more productive, and even have the option to sell via live stream the products that you want to sell. So thank you guys for watching and see you soon.